Hey YouTube, ID4 Khan here, and today we have the Mercedes EQA 250, if I'm right, and I put it alongside of my ID4, so we can have a direct comparison between these cars. I would have another 30 minutes with this car, so it's nothing actually to go through all of the differences between them, so let's talk very quick about the car, exterior, interior, and the trunk of it. It's a front wheel drive. So the engine electric motor is at the front. This car has currently 18 inch with 235, 55, 18, if I'm right. 235, 55, 18. Rear is the same. So we have a square setup. It's currently bridged with Bridgestone. Yeah, T005, so that's fine. But immediately you will see that the front trunk of a front hood like this is pretty much longer than the ID4. And the main reason is that the electric motor is here. So let's check it out. Let me check. It's right there, the handle. Where's the thingy? Right there. This is great. Volkswagen, why don't you give us that €3 thingy? It just works, you know? But yeah, immediately you will see the engine of this. The front electric engine. And first look, it looks to be not that really compact, because the front engine is right there. That was the front hood. We don't have a frunk. You have some spaces for the frunk, but don't use it. It doesn't have it. We have only a trunk. Well, this is the front view. It has a closed grille. And when you're looking at with the ID4 between that, both are at the front, the logos. But the car looks to be a bit lower, the nose, this edge. It's a bit lower than the ID4. And it has LED high performance. That looks to be a projector. This looks to be a LED, and that's a reflector for your high beams. Let me check if I can show you the key. This is the key of this car. And if I unlock, it will show you the blinkers. And if I close it again, it will show you the blinkers again. So that is fine. Front assist, closed grille, park assist at the front, but it doesn't have any camera. It looks to be a camera hole, but it doesn't have a camera. So it's like a plastic thingy. So it doesn't have the option for that. Anyhow, now let's go to the interior. Or at least let's talk about the exterior a bit. You have nice rims. You have the EQA logo right there. I will try to find out which version this was so I can write all the stats of this car. And maybe the most important, EQA, Mercedes logo, and we have that nice LED bar. And if you're comparing between these two, personally, it has the same styling because it has a LED bar, but I do like the more blackish variant of the ID4. It's just too much EV6. But Hyundai, the new Kias has such LED bar, so opening the car again, and then we can check out the port. This port is gigantic. I thought my port was big, but let me show you the failures for the tires. Great. And then we have here our CCS ports, and bam, it's nice that it's you can open them individually, but or you can open them both at the sideways. So but let's talk about this big thing right there. It's even bigger than mine, actually. And I thought mine was big. That thing is much, 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 much bigger. Bam. Anyhow, if we're still at the rear, let's talk about the trunk. If it's possible, it should be possible to open the trunk. Let's use the key. Okay, these are some personal belongings of the driver, so sorry about that. But you can see immediately what the usage is of this trunk. It's not the biggest. You should a bit more compare it with the ID3, because the equivalent of the ID4 is the EQC, size-wise. This is a bit shorter from the rear. Maybe you can see it, but it's my rear is a bit more further back. So where my tail light starts, this ends as a trunk. But what do you have here more? Pockets here, pockets there. Charge cable, nice Manicast Type 2. And we do have a 12 volt right there. We do, right there, and that's it. Do we have a second floor? We do, with a plastic back, and not very much. So, anyhow, time is running out, and to give you a quick comparison between the two. This goes there. It's like my full arm. Sorry about light. And I can just touch it right here without being inside. So that's around the difference of the trunk of these cars. Put it at the top, press it. And I would say these are the exteriors very quickly. Let's go to the interior. Do we have a keyless access? No, we don't have keyless access. I don't know if it isn't the option or not. I will check it out after this video. Key, because you don't always know which version you will get. Now, first look. Nice steering wheel, nice view, nice interior here. And of course, a nice emblem here on the door. Let's talk about the door. Nice, I would say it's, how did you call this? It's not velvet, but I think it's something like microfasal, something like that. It's not velvet, but I don't know, I will figure it out. Nice door handles, buttons for all your windows, front, rear, left, right, etc. And seat heating at the front, which is nice. We don't have seat ventilation. That is for the more expensive Mercedes cars, but for the EQA to have seat heating, it's a nice plus. Actually, it's needed. If you're driving electric, you need a seat heater and a steering wheel heater. So, both are really, really needed. Sorry about the cars, etc. It can be pretty loud. Now, let's go, before we go inside, let's see the seat. It's leather on the outside with microfasal velvet on the inside. Right there, right there. So it's fine, it's comfortable, and the sides of this gives a bit great support. My ID4 is not that deep, so it gives a bit less support for people like me, which are a bit thicker. But the IONIQ 5 had even less support than the ID4. Personally, that's just my personal feeling. But yeah, what does this seat offer? We have legs, which is manual. The going down is manual. Going front, everything is manual. So only, and this also manual. This goes up and side. And this electric part is the Lenden support, which is this, which goes up, down, side, inwards and outwards. But hey, that's it. What do you have more? Pedals, metal with rubber, that's it, not that special. And it looks to be the AMG line from the inside and outside. Now, let's enjoy the screen now. What do we see? No, it's starting. It's not starting really. It just shows the logo. So we need to press start. And now we see everything. All right, that was the alarm. I don't know why. Is it working? It's working? Okay, that was the alarm. Don't know why actually, but it's the alarm. But yeah, this is the screen. Now, before we go to the screen, let's talk about the steering wheel. It's very, very nice and fat and thick, I would say, so it's nice. Touches, you can use, don't show it, so we can try to show it, go back, and you can actually use your mate, what are you, just start. Good, start, I'm ready to drive. Great, why it's not that hard. And now, man, I need to use my seatbelt. Uno momento. I have 8 minutes left with the car. So, steering wheel. Okay. You can, with your left, you can change the things on your home screen. It's maybe that hard, but if I look at that, that is that. Blinkers, which the front camera will see. Of at least the sound. This is the bot. Alarm sounds. We do have the lights at the front. Lights. It's LED, so that's great. Do we have at the rear? No, we don't. We close it and now we have, let's use the touchpad. It's I don't really have that much of the time, so we're going really fast. We do have pedals for more and less regenerating. You go down. This is your gear selector, front and backwards. If we go backwards, we do only have the rear. Do we see more? It's right there. Straight. Can we change the pedal? You will see a D plus if I go plus, and if I go minus, you will see D minus. And that's the steering wheel. I just can't show you much of it. Go home, and then you can go with your steering right here. And then press, let's not comfort, go back. Go back, EQ, and then you can select, and not everything is with, yeah, good. Can we do this? Can you use this? Can we have more? This one? Ah, usage, you can see the usage of the car. So that is great. This is awesome. And even this, ah, great. These type of graphs are really handy for your driving. And it can help you understanding with what the car does with consumption wise. And this gives the total usage here. So that's great. Locking mechanism is right here. So I didn't see this first. And actually it's pretty great, this place. You have everything on your left hand. Now the center console, this is the key. You can close it. You have here ambient light on the left and the right. Let me put the key right here before it acts. USB-C on the left, and I don't see a charger, so that's all right. Holder with personal belongings. It's pretty deep, by the way. It's right there. And your, this is normally your gear knob, because it's an EV, it's there. Or is this a stuff? No, it's not. It's not a gear knob. You can use this for, again, moving. And you can press home and move sideways. So that is nothing new. But it feels really, really solid, fast, quick, fluid. That's the word I was saying. Fluid. It's really fluid. And what do you have left? You have also the same on the right. And we have a glove box, a relatively small one, but it has a LED, a light. So that's great. Also a place to put some keys or some documents straight. So Interesting. So, it's time to go. So, that was the video about the EQA, Mercedes EQA 250. I hope you enjoyed the car itself, the difference between the ID.4 and the EQA 250. And then it's time to say goodbye. Thanks for watching, and I will see you again in my next video. Later!